work on that alternator yet?
I suppose. We better get to work. I can't play the guitar all day. Good morning, Jeep lovers. Tom here with my CJ-5 Willys Jeep. Today we're working on a generator to alternator conversion kit. The generator was working, but I'll show you the problem if you want to come on over here. They had a double pulley on the crankshaft with narrow belts, and they were running one belt from here to the water pump, and there was no tensioner on it. And they're running another narrow belt from here to the generator, which has a narrow pulley. And I wanted to go back to the proper system, which is one wide belt running the alternator and the water pump. So we had to replace the crankshaft pulley, which we did. It wasn't any problem. We did end up getting a double one because the way the water pump is, that's the only way we could get it to line up. So let me set this down. So what we've done here, the person before me had a set of gauges inside, which is what these two wires are going to. This is coming off the battery terminal. And then this is returning to the standard wiring to get power into the ignition and the vehicle for lights and all that. So I'm going to take off this regulator since we don't need that anymore. The new alternator has an internal regulator. So this is no longer necessary. The generator is no longer necessary. Heavy old thing. Still works though. Worth some money. So if you do this, don't get rid of your generator. Okay, I'm going to take off this wire nut. I know that's not standard factory stuff. And these two wires go to the aftermarket ammeter that somebody has at some point has put on. This goes to an oil pressure gauge in there. And the other one goes to a temperature gauge. So I got a feeling that somebody has put this on because they're certainly not standard gauges. So I think I'm just going to bypass the gauges for now because running your alternator through the ammeter isn't quite correct anyway. We're working on our alternator wiring still. I've cut my main wire to length, and we soldered this lug onto it, and we put the heat shrink on there that they give you in the kit. We're looking at the wiring of the alternator after we took off the voltage regulator. So the alternator is wired from the plug back to the battery post with the little wire that comes with your harness. Then there's a bigger wire that goes from the battery post down to where the end of your positive battery cable is, which is at the solenoid. So that's going to charge our battery. That's going to let the alternator charge our battery. The white wire, which has a resistor in it, so don't lose your resistor in there. That's going to go into the cab, under the dash, to the back of the ignition switch on the post that's marked ignition. Now, these came off of the voltage regulator. One, this one is for the temperature gauge that's in the instrument cluster. And this littler one is for the idiot light for the generator. That used to tell you if your generator went out. But I'm not going to use those. I'm going to just tape those off and get them out of the way. So they're taken care of. Now, the way it used to work is that this wire right here came off of the voltage regulator and went down. This used to come into the same place we're charging in, and it came back up and charged your battery through with the generator. But now we're going to use this to draw power off of the system to go over to the dash. I'm not exactly sure what all this runs. It might run like the lights or the windshield wipers or whatever. But this goes over towards the dash and supplies power for some of the parts of the electrical system. There's also a wire that comes off the main positive battery cable that goes down here inside this harness that also supplies some power over to the electrical system. So there are two power supplies that are supplying the electrical system. Now, the white wire, we're going to go through the firewall. We're going to go into the back of the ignition switch to the post that's marked IGN. So let's go look at that now. Well, let's see what we have behind this dash here. I'd like to get this ignition switch out. So here's the white wire. I've brought it through the firewall. I've soldered an end on there, and I've put some shrink wrap on there, or some whatever you call it. And we're going to just mount that right onto our IGN switch. So this energizes when you turn the ignition switch on. When this had the generator in it, we had an ammeter in here. And right here. And I'm going to remove that when we put the alternator in, and I'm going to just put in a voltage gauge. So they had these heavy wires, and they had all the current from the generator coming through this ammeter. So I'm going to take these heavy wires off because I don't need that for a voltage gauge. So I'm removing the nuts from the back of the bracket that's holding the gauge in. And there it is. Oop. This one has the light still attached, so I have to take that off. But here we go. Let's go replace this with a voltage gauge, and we'll be on our way to being done with this job. I went to Napa, and I got a volt gauge. I think they're like $20, $22, something like that. And I'm going to wire this into the where that ammeter was, and that should fit right in there, mount right up. But this doesn't need nearly as big of wiring. This can just go to ground. These wires are for the light, but when you wire this up, this just goes to ground and then any positive source for electricity. And this will just tell you if you have, you should have around 13, 14 volts with our new alternator. Okay, we're making our jumper for our voltage gauge. Okay, trigger. Perfect. That's going to be our negative wire. This is just going to go to ground. So this is our voltage gauge. You could call it a meter, but when you say meter, people get confused with a test meter. So the back of it, the left side goes to ground. That's what we have here. Just going to bolt it on and hook the other side to ground. And we're going to make up the other one to go on the right post here as you're looking at it from the back. And that's going to go to a source that's on when the ignition is on. So we'll do that next. Okay, we have our gauge wired up. We have our lug soldered on there good. And it just has a backing bracket that goes on like so from behind. We have our new voltage gauge or meter, whichever you like to call it, installed. We have, when you turn the key on, we have it activated. So it's reading about a little over 12 volts. And when we start the engine, the generator or the alternator should kick it up to around 14. There you go, even at idle, over 14. We're maxed out almost, but our voltage regulator looks like it's set at about 14 and a half. So let's go around and look at the, we'll put the meter on the actual battery. So if we put our test meter onto the battery terminal, we get 1473, even at a low idle. So that worked, working pretty well. And our belt looks pretty good. It looks like it's running really through. So for a recap on what we did to switch from the generator to the alternator, we've got the A200 bracket, I believe it's called. And we took quite a while to get that figured out and get the alternator lined up properly. And we had to do some shimming with washers. in both the back and the front to get it out far enough. And also one other thing we had to do was this fan is quite close to the alternator. You can see there's only about 3/16 of an inch. And I had to take some off that. This is a wide pulley. It's a wide pulley on the alternator, and because we have the wide belt. And I had to saw off about 3/16 of an inch because it was just right at the fan. So we did that. So we had to take the nut off, and I took it off the back side of the nut, not the head. And so we did the wiring. We wired the alternator output to the solenoid on the starter. The other part went to the ignition switch. And this part that was on the voltage regulator, the old voltage regulator, this just got hooked back together and comes from the same lug where we hooked our alternator up and draws current off and goes to the other electrical systems in the Jeep. And there's also another wire that comes off the battery right here, off the positive, and that feeds some other systems, the electrical systems. We came and took the white wire and put it to the back of the ignition switch where it says ignition. We swapped out the ammeter for a voltage meter or a voltage gauge, which is reading nicely, works well. Reads 12 and then it reads 14 when we're fired up. So everything's good. So it's not a real difficult project, but it does take a little while. I think the hardest part was getting that bracket right, and we've got her lined up real nice now. That thing is straight as an arrow. You can see right there. It's running true and it's straight, and we're straight down to the crankshaft pulley. So it all looks good. So I hope you guys enjoy doing your generator to alternator conversion. I hope this video helps you a little bit. It's not that difficult. There's a couple different ways you can do it, but I think this is the best way that we did it. So good luck on your conversion, and thanks for watching the video. We'll see you next time.